Okay,
right
okay,
on.
Okay.
Right on. Bro, please break this. Please set the table.
All right, so everybody has no secret. Everybody knows Katt Williams has been going crazy in the media right now.
Oh, yeah.
The podcast interview with Club Shay Shay. Shannon Sharp.
Shout out Shannon Sharp. Big Unk.
Shout out Big Shay Shay.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? First of all, I love the way that they did that interview.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? I feel like he gave him the space to really air out a lot of stuff that needed to be aired out.
Oh, yeah.
I actually saw a video earlier of Orlando Brown responding to the whole shit. And the main piece that he said was, somebody pissed Katt off.
Oh, yeah.
Who was it that pissed Katt off?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I agree.
And he did drop a gem and say it was Kevin Hart.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
He didn't say it was Kevin Hart that pissed him off. But
yeah,
anyways,
yeah.
What I wanted to highlight about Katt Williams is not only is he a hilarious individual.
Yes.
But he always keeps it P.
Of course. He always keeps it P.
Whether that's big player, whether that's pimp, whether that's professional.
Exactly.
The man carries himself as a man should.
Big P, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Regardless of how the media tried to portray him, tried to have him looking crazy and have mm-hmm. him doing this, that's what the media will do. The media will spend whatever they need to spend to make you look a certain way.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? And that's just on some deeper shit.
Wow.
But one of the quotes that really made waves that he did state is, it was retweeted by this lady here. I was going to say, fine ass nene, interesting. I didn't look at her photos, but I'm going to have to take a peek.
Of course.
So if you wanted me to speak more highly of you, then perhaps you should have treated me better. You don't get to narrate my story of my experiences with you. Now, this is deep on so many levels.
That's deep. Break it down, bro. That's deep, bro. Yeah.
You have to be cognizant on how you treat people.
For sure.
How you approach people.
For sure.
Because that shit will definitely come around to bite you in the ass.
That's how it goes, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Katt Williams been in the industry for a long time, doing a lot of things from comedy specials to movies, right, to this, to that.
Right.
Not only that, but he apparently does a lot of, you know what I'm saying, community work. He helps a lot of, you know, up and coming comedians and whatnot in the industry,
yeah,
without any recognition. People don't, you know what I'm saying, he's not doing it to be recognized for that.
Right.
He's doing it because that's just the kind of man that he is.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? He's been, yeah, in that position on the come up. He understands the grind. He understands what it takes to make it to the top.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And so I got to respect the man on so many different levels, but you have to pay attention to how you treat people.
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? Because everybody's going to have their own experience. Everybody's going to have their own perspective on what they got from you.
Exactly.
And if you don't come with that correct energy, best believe, people remember how you make them feel.
Right.
Above all things.
Right.
If you don't remember somebody for anything, you will remember how they treated you and how they made you feel in certain moments and certain experiences.
That's 100% true. But, you know, in our line of work, right, what we do, one perspective I have is, like, no matter how good you are, there are always going to be people who don't like what you're doing. They don't like what you've done.
Mm-hmm.
They don't like how you went about something. There's always several perspectives.
100%.
On you, on me, on anyone.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? Because we can't be everything to everyone at the same time.
Exactly. Not everybody is going to receive things the same way.
Exactly. So while I do agree with you, I agree 100%, you do got to be careful and cognizant of how you're treating people, because you never know.
Right.
You never know how that's going to go. But at the same time, you're going to be the bad guy to the people.
You're going to be the bad guy to somebody.
This is just how the game, you know what I mean? That's how the game goes.
This is 100%.
And so with that being said, when it comes to specifically the Katt Williams and the Kevin Hart situation and that whole situation, I like them both.
I do.
I got respect for them both. 100%. I think they're both. Katt Williams, in terms of his comedic peak, elite. That dude is excellent.
100%.
Funny as hell. Okay. Smart. Observant. You know, he pays attention to the details. He's a great comedian. You get what I'm saying? But Kevin Hart, I got respect for Kevin Hart for his business mentality.
He is. He's making moves.
You get what I'm saying? Like,
he's making moves.
You can say, like, I guess Katt Williams insinuated that Kevin Hart was a plant, right?
Mm, okay.
This is what he said. He had to be a plant because he was out there. How was he out there in New York and never been to the West? But then he comes to the West and automatically has, you know, soul planes, movies, different shows that he's doing. You know what I mean?
How quickly he blew up.
But to me, it's like, to me, Kevin is smart.
That's facts.
He's smart. You know, there's a game. Life is a game.
It is.
You get what I'm saying? And certain people just don't be operating at the higher levels.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, take a lady, a person that was at work, that we work with, they no longer with at the job anymore, right?
Heard about that.
You heard about that somehow. We ain't gonna get into no specifics, but you know what I'm saying, right?
I do.
But the point is, she wasn't operating at the highest possible level that you can operate.
She wasn't playing the game the way the game needed to be played.
For sure. And so when you look at to extrapolate that back to Kevin Hart be playing the game. He know how to play. He's smart.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? He understands how to. He can make fun of himself.
Right, right, right.
He can make people feel comfortable, but he's also smart. He can drop game on you.
Oh God.
He can talk that boss talk with you.
Okay.
However way you want to do it, he can do it, and that will take you a long way.
That's facts.
You get what I'm saying? So from Cat Williams' perspective, it's like how did Kevin Hart get? How did he right, had to right. be a plant? No. Not necessarily, respectfully.
Right, right. In your opinion.
I gotta disagree. Kevin Hart just, he know how to play the game.
He moved the way he needed to move.
He moved the way he needed to move. It's a combination of ambition.
Facts.
Social aptitude.
Right.
Hard work. Going for it. Putting yourself out there. You get what I'm saying?
Facts.
Understanding people. Like, it's not
just... It's a collective effort. It ain't just who he know, who he rubbed elbows with, who he happened to bump into, who he happened to do favors for, who favors were done for him.
Exactly.
It's more to the game than just that.
And I feel like Katt Williams don't want to... He just don't want to play that game.
He don't want to highlight that. Yeah, and he don't want to...
You know?
Some people, there's limits. Everybody has their limits. Everybody has things that they're not willing to do for something that they want.
Exactly.
And that's perfectly okay.
100%.
You know what I mean? That just is what it is. But